Hello, I'm Mr. Arjun, a lecturer in mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. The subject of theology is not for the university theologian, dead in letters, have no spirit at all. Holy Spirit is common sense, and which in Punjabi we call Surti. And if you have no common sense, you cannot understand gospel. And here I am going to tell you about Garden of Eden. We have heard about Garden of Eden, the story and all that. And it actually existed. And it was in the Israel, the promised land, in the Garden of Eden. When Abraham and his generations, they were faithful to Abraham and to Yahweh. So whatever you see with your two naked eyes, it all belongs to Yahweh, and we call it Brahma in Hindi, and in Arabic they call it Khuda. So this nature, which we call Kudrat, is of Brahma, Khuda, and Yahweh. Yahweh was the father of Jesus. That's why his name was, Hebrew name is Yeshua, made of two words, Yah from Yahweh, and Shua or Shiva means the primal Adam. So Jesus was the firstborn of Yahweh, the second Adam. Mary was surrogate mother and Joseph foster father. That's why Jesus addressed Mary as woman and not as his mother. It's only at the cross when he was being killed. Then he told them, look, mother, all your people, all your Judah tribe people have killed me. And this is a dark age. And all this creation that you see with two naked eyes, they are pot. Force. The soul inside is of Elohim, Allah Parbrahm. So we have natural and supernatural fathers. So this is the force, three here. Devil's cross, holy and evil. They are of works, karma. And they are creation of Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda. And the soul in these pots is from Elohim, the middle candle, which is Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, same thing. He is the father of our souls. And here we have, father is our, Yahweh is our father. Yahweh created Adam and Eve and everything. So it was Yahweh who bring Abram from the Iraq area. He was of Semitic race. Semitic race is a mix of Negro and Aryan. So that people who will come and see Abram and his land, they would not be hated by either by black or by the Negro, black or white, Aryan. So it was Yahweh who bring Abram from Iraq area, and he came alone, solitary, and made him to settle in the Middle East, in the Promised Land. So the promised land belonged to Abraham when he had the faith in God. Abraham and Sarah. Sarah is his wife. So Abraham was like Adam, noble man, and Sarah was Eve. And they were living in the promised land, which was Garden of Eden, in the company of Yahweh. Yahweh is the God of Israel. So this promised land was lush green, milk and honey. So far, the sons of Abraham were faithful to Abraham and to Yahweh. But whenever they became unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, the same Garden of Eden, promised land, turned into barren, desert, and they have to leave. And this is when the Jacob had 12 sons. The 11, they were crook, they were liars. And the only one who was speaking the truth was Joseph, who was a righteous person, who was the salt of Abraham. The other saltless people, 11 of them, they were jealous of him that we tell lies to our father and he tell the truth. So we are put to a shame, you know. So they said, why not we kill him and get rid of him so that we can have our own way. So instead of killing him, they sold him as a slave to the Egyptian. And as soon as Joseph left the promised land, there were none who were faithful to Abraham or to Yahweh. Abraham is the father of the faithful and not of the unfaithful. So Abraham kicked the 11 crook brethren of Joseph out of the promised land. And this happened that Yahweh stopped rain. All that you see that in nature, storm, hurricane coming in America, they are all brought by Yahweh. Such hurricane don't happen in Russia, because these people in America who are ruling, which is Mammon and media, is in the hand of the Jews. And Jews are unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh. They are the sons of Satan. And they are causing all the problem in the world. In the Middle East, now the Venezuela is going to be. So Yahweh is the one who beat them through storms and hurricanes and other floods and other things. So the people suffer, you know. A Mammon. In God, God is Mammon free, whereas Mammon is Satan. And God is Mammon free, as Jesus was Mammon free. So the 11 crook brethren of Joseph, they had to leave the promised land for the Egyptian land. Went to Egypt, where Joseph, having the salt of his forefather Abraham, he welcomed them and looked after them. Then Moses brought them back, faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh, and the same land became lush green, Garden of Eden again, or Father welcomed them with open arms and he gave the fattened calf. The whole story has been told by Jesus in the parable of the prodigal son, where the father is Abraham, elder son is Ishmael, and the younger one is Isaac. So the Garden of Eden still exists, where the people are faithful to faithful to their tribal fathers, and to Yahweh. And that is in Brazilian jungle, you can see them, you know, living peacefully, plenty to eat, and nothing to worry about, because they are the company of their creator, Yahweh. Yahweh is the creator. From Yahweh, when you are faithful to Yahweh, or to your tribal father, then you have to seek our supernatural father. Then you have the spirituality as well. So first morality and then spirituality. Jesus had 12 laborers and no disciple. The root of the word disciple is discipline. And the rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees, they disciplined the natural boys, 12 to 16 years old, by teaching them the moral law of Moses. And that created kingdom of heaven. But when they themselves became corrupt and they became hypocrite, then it created hell and bribery and all that. Money mammon came in, and then criterion had to come to preach gospel of righteousness. So anybody who is righteous, he is son of God. Anyone who is unrighteous, who does injustice, he is son of Satan. And today this world is full of injustices. I have experienced injustices from ombudsmen, from many other letting agents, the property agent, he cheated me. So cheating is the commonplace, and much more in India than in Britain. So Garden of Eden, it was the promised land. So far they remained faithful to Abraham and faithful to Yahweh. And when they are faithful to Yahweh, then they can seek the royal kingdom of God, which is greater than the Garden of Eden. So here they are, John the Baptist, he baptized the Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham. And Jesus in the name of his heavenly father, Yahweh. And these are the people who they are of Holy Spirit. And they were seeking this narrow gate. And they sought this narrow gate. And they killed the ego, they buried the ego of their tribal seed in soil to produce a plant which had the identity of the tribe implicit, not explicit. So then they grafted it to the true vine, Christ Jesus, to suck their daily bread, daily living bread, or flesh of Jesus. And they took it to their heart, which is the stomach, ear, spiritual mouth, stomach, heart. Then through intuition, logical reasoning, they view logo. And then they preach gospel. And when they preach gospel, they throw the light of our supernatural Father. And they become his sons, sons of the Most High. So sons of the Most High preach gospel from their heart. Christian, the dead in letters. They are the ones who teach in the university letters, dead letters. Dead letters is old wine. They are getting drunk with the old wine, desirous not the new. So with this hoodie, or printed hoodie, which is a message, you know, which is this one. I went to Oxford University and they threw me out of the seminar because they did not like the light. And that is no surprise for me, because Jesus was hated by the Jerusalem theologians when he was preaching gospel, but he was loved by the common man. So theology are the subject of religion is for the common man and not for the university professors in dead letters who come to the churches, become priests, because we don't need priests anymore. To get rid of these new rabbis or these priests, Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, he died on the cross. And there you are, they have cropped up, creating problem in the world, and so much so that people don't want to know religion. They hate it, and they have become atheists, who are good people. So atheists are like the tax collectors. They would not used to go to their synagogue on Sabbath, and they proclaimed it sinner for breaking the moral of Moses. So much more I can tell, and hope you understand. All the Garden of Eden was the promised land when the sons of Abraham, they were faithful to him and faithful to Yahweh as Moses created them, made them after repenting in the wilderness for 40 years. Then they were faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh, and that is why they bring him out of it, and the sea parted. All that miracle happened. So they were protected by Yahweh. And we call it Khuda Hafiz. Khuda Hafiz. And because our life is in the, it depends upon our soul, which is our father is Allah, Parbrahm, Elohim. So when we part, you know, we say Khuda Hafiz, and if we are meeting each other, inshallah. Inshallah means if Allah be willing, we will meet again, if we are living again. So our Father God blesses everyone alike.